Welcome to Igor's Concept Learning Room. In this video, we'll continue with stoichiometry and more concepts. So this is lesson number two. We are dealing with calculations from chemical equations. So what exactly are we going to deal with in this lesson? Under calculations from equations. So we want to know how to calculate the mole to mole calculations. We also want to know how to calculate the mass to mole calculations. And finally, we'll wrap up lesson two with the mass to mass calculations. All right, then, let's get down to business. All right, but just in case of supporting our productions, you can inform somebody about the online learning and see who gets interested. All right, so let's get down to business. The first thing that we are dealing with is the mole to mole calculations, right? So we are dealing with the mole to mole calculations. So just pay attention to my blackboard as I teach. All right, so mole to mole calculations, this is how it is done. So let's look at some example questions. The first question reads, how many moles of chlorine are required to react 2.5 moles of calcium to produce calcium chloride? How many moles of chlorine? So you take note, how many moles of chlorine are required to react 2.5 moles of calcium to produce calcium chloride? All right, now you remember from way back, we actually looked at, how to write the chemical equations. You convert a chemical sentence into a chemical equation. So now here they are saying chlorine are required to react. So if we are to write an equation there, it is calcium plus chlorine, which will give us calcium chloride. So now it is very important that you know how to write these chemical equations and always ensure that chemical equations are balanced and they've got their chemical symbols, right? For example, calcium is a solid at RTP, all metals are. Chlorine is a gas, so that's why we are writing Cl2 and a G. Then this one, you combine them. Remember, we looked at how to construct formulas as well. So you just write, for example, you write the calcium there, which has got a valence of 2, okay? And also a chlorine, which has got a valence of 1. So you can interchange these two, right? So if we interchange those two, we are going to have a CaCl2. So that is how we find the formula for what? Calcium chloride. And you write it there. Then secondly, you have to make sure that this equation is actually balanced, right? So I'm explaining the stages on how you can make these calculations. So make sure that this equation is balanced. So let's check. We have one calcium here. Let's go to the right. We also have one calcium. We have two chlorine here. We also have two chlorine. So this one is already balanced, right? So after writing a balanced chemical equation, so let's just call this one step one. Okay, so step one, we are saying you write a balanced chemical equation, then you continue step two there. We are saying you now express this one in terms of what? Mole ratios. So we are going to say number of moles of calcium, okay, number of moles of calcium over one. Now, where is this one coming from? It's over these numbers, the coefficients that are in front here. So if in front there is nothing, it means there is a one. So this one should be equal to the number of moles of this guy here, the Cl2, so Cl2 over one also. So we have Cl2 over one, all right? Because there is nothing in front here, there is a one. So meaning there is an invisible coefficient of one. So this one should be equal to, also here there is a one. So it would be number of moles of calcium chloride, okay, number of moles of calcium chloride over one. So this is what we have. All right, so this is the equation. Now, here, how are you going to know which ones you're going to use? You are simply going to pick on the one that have been what, highlighted here. So they're saying how many moles of chlorine are required to react 2.5 moles of calcium to produce calcium sulfate. So now, what they are asking, how many moles of chlorine? So definitely, chlorine has to be part and parcel of the equation you're going to use. Okay, so how many moles of chlorine are required to react 2.5 moles of calcium. So also calcium, you need it because they've given you 2.5 moles of calcium. So as a result, we have chosen that the equation we are going to use is actually just this part. So we are saying number of moles of calcium over 1 is equal to number of moles of chlorine over 1. Okay, what does this mean? So number of moles of calcium, we don't know. So it will just be number. So here, number of moles of calcium has given us actually 2.5. So we are going to write 2.5 over 1 is equal to number of moles of chlorine. Okay, number of moles of chlorine, we don't know. So it remains NCl2 over 1. And thereafter, we can cross multiply. So this one, 1 times number of moles of chlorine, this one is just going to give us number of moles of chlorine is equals to, then 2.5 times 1, it will also be 2.5 moles. So it means we have determined now the number of moles of chlorine is actually equivalent to 2.5 moles. And there you have found your answer. All right, let's look at example number 2, see if we'll be able to pick up something. So let me just divide my board to ensure that working enough. All right, so first thing here, you read the question. They're saying how many moles of carbon dioxide, okay, they've been said carbon dioxide, will be produced by complete combustion of 2 moles of glucose according to the equation, this one here. So let's ensure that this equation is balanced. Since they've already given us an equation, our task will just be to ensure that it is balanced. So let's check. We have 6 carbon here. We also have 6 carbon here. We have, let's see, hydrogens here. We have, okay, this 12 hydrogens. Let's check. Even here we have 6 times 2, which is 12 hydrogens. Then oxygens, we actually have, this is, we have 18. This 6 here plus 6 times 2, which is 12. So we have 12 plus 6, which is 18. Let's check here. Here we also have 6 times the 2 here, which is 12. 6 times the 1, which is 6, so also 18. By now, people know how to balance their equations. Then the question is asking, how many moles of carbon dioxide? All right, so before we can even reach that far, the first thing that you're going to do is to express this equation in terms of mole ratios. So we are saying this is number of moles of glucose, C6H12. So this is C6H12O6. Then over, so this one is over because in front here there is an invisible one. So this one will be over 1, which is equal to number of moles of oxygen. So number of moles of O2, this one should be over 6 because there is a 6 in front here. And this one should be equal to number of moles of this carbon dioxide here, CO2. This one should be over 6, okay? Over 6, which should be equal to number of moles of the water, H2O, over 6, right? This 6 that is in front. So you write that one. The next thing, you just single out what you're interested in. Since they've said how many moles of carbon dioxide, so carbon dioxide should be part of, will be produced by complete combustion of 2 moles of glucose. So you know that also glucose is part of you. As a result, you are forming an equation which says number of moles of glucose, which is C6H12 and O6 is over 1. This one is over 1, should be equivalent to the number of moles of carbon dioxide here. So CO2, this one here, over 6. So this is the only part that you are interested in. So you singled out this one. That one, that is the one that we have here. Then the next step is you substitute. Since they've said number of moles of glucose, they've told us 2 moles of glucose. So that one will just be 2 over 1 is actually equal to number of moles of carbon dioxide, which is what we are looking for, over 6. Then these are equations. You are just going to cross multiply there. So this one will be number of moles of carbon dioxide there is simply equivalent to, so number of moles of carbon dioxide is simply equivalent to, you multiply, so this is over 6 rather, not 1, this 6 here over 6, so it will be 2 times 6, and this one will give us what? 12. All right, so this one is going to give us 12 moles. And there we have our answer. And you have determined successively. All right, so that is how you handle such questions. So this is a more to more calculations where they will give you the number of moles of one species so that you can use that one to find the number of moles of another species. So the simple steps are, the first thing is you are going to write a balanced chemical equation, then you express it in terms of mole ratios, then you figure out which ones you are interested in. So figure out the two that you are interested in, and you're going to use those to find what you are looking for. And that is how it should be done. All right, we go to, this is the practice exercise number one. See if you had something, practice, and make sure that you get back to me on time. All right, let's go to B, more to mass calculations. Remember, we started by dealing with more to more. Now we are dealing with more to mass, meaning they will give you the number of moles of something, then you are going to find the mass. All right, that's why we're saying more to mass. We are converting from moles to mass. They give you the moles of something to so that you can find the mass of something. Let's look at the sample question here. So the sample question, they are saying, what mass of hydrogen can be produced by reacting 6 moles of aluminium with hydrochloric acid? And thankfully, they've already given us the equation, but don't take it for granted. It's not always that they'll provide the equation. So have knowledge about how equations can be done. All right, so I've just created my work area there. This is my workspace. Let's see how we can calculate these things. All right, so the first question here, they've asked us, what mass of hydrogen can be produced by reacting 6 moles, so 6 moles of aluminium with hydrochloric acid? So the first thing is, let's ensure that this equation here is balanced, right? So if this equation is balanced, if you don't want to write to express everything as in terms of mole ratios, so here, this is more to mass. So the first thing you have to do is treat this one as a more to more. So first of all, you do as more to more, so that like here they are saying, what mass of hydrogen, all right? So they want us to find the mass of hydrogen. But you cannot just find the mass of hydrogen like that. You first of all have to know the number of moles of hydrogen. So you are going to find these moles of hydrogen by using the 6 moles of aluminium that you've been given. So since it's 6 moles and you want to first find the moles, so it becomes a more to more calculation. So you first of all do a more to more, then afterwards that's when you convert the moles to mass. All right, let's see how that one happens. So I've said, instead of expressing everything, okay, if you want, because that's what we are used, you can just, here I'm interested in aluminium and hydrogen. I can go direct, or I can first of all express everything, but let me show you another method also. You're just going to say number of moles of aluminium there over 2, because this one is already balanced, by the way. So number of moles of this aluminium over 2, the 2 that is in front, should be equal to the number of moles of hydrogen. I've already figured out my interest. So the number of moles of hydrogen over 3. All right, so this is what I have, over 3, because the 3 is in front. Then now I begin to change. They've told me that 6 moles of aluminium. So this one will be 6 over 2 is actually equal to number of moles of hydrogen over 3. All right, so over 3. Then we cross multiply this one. So I'm going to have 2 number of moles of hydrogen here. So 2 number of moles of hydrogen is equal to 6 times 3, that is 18. So we divide both sides by 2, also this side. So we divide there, there, this one and that one cancels. So we remain with number of moles of hydrogen is actually equal to, so 18 divided by 2, this one is giving me 9 moles. So we have found 9 moles, right? So 9 moles is my answer. Now, remember, they are asking for what mass. So now, that is when I'm going to use my formula, which says number of moles is equals to mass over molar mass. Remember, in lesson 1, we looked at how to find the molar mass. So here, this one, you just say, okay, since I have this one, I make mass the subject of the formula. So this one will be just 1 times m. So we have mass is simply equal to number of moles multiplied by what? molar mass. All right, so this is what we have. So this one is equals to the number of moles according to this one. We have actually found 9 moles. Okay, so number of moles, we know it's 9 moles, multiplying with the molar mass. Remember, hydrogen, since it's hydrogen here, it is H2. We are just finding H2, this part here, H2. 3, we've already used it in the calculation, so we forget about it. So we're just going to use H2. Now, hydrogen is 1, so 1 times 2 is 2. So this one is also giving us 2 grams per mole. Remember, molar mass has got units. So if we multiply this one, the mole here and this mole cancel, leaving us with 18 grams. All right, so we have successively converted from the number of moles that we found, we've converted them to moles, to mass. So this is how you find the mole to mass calculations. This is how you are supposed to treat it. All right, let's see if we can look at a second scenario example and see how best we can understand this similar concept. All right, so the question reads, how many grams of oxygen are required to react with 0.3 moles of aluminium to produce aluminium oxide? So they are asking for what? How many grams of oxygen? So we are interested in oxygen. Okay, supposing the equation was not written to us, we are supposed to write this equation. So let's be acquainted with how to write chemical equations on our own without any assistance. So ensure that the equation is balanced. All right, so we just figured out we're interested in this one. Reacts with 0.3 moles of aluminium. So also we are interested in this one. So we just need to equate this and that, and we are good to go. But before we do that, ensure that the equation is balanced. So we have 4 aluminium here, and here we also have 4, because 2 times this 2 there, that is a 4. Then we have how many oxygen? 6. 3 times 2, that is 6. Even this 2 times this 3, that is 6. So this equation is already balanced. All right, so we are just going to say number of moles of aluminium, number of moles of aluminium over 4 is equal to the number of moles of oxygen over 3. So remember, a mole to mass calculation, you first of all have to treat as a mole to mole, then you just convert the moles to what? To mass. So since they are asking about oxygen, we want to find the number of moles of oxygen, then we convert those number of moles to mass. And this is how we're going to do it. All right, so number of moles of aluminium they've given us is 0.3. So here we are going to have 0.3. So 0.3 over 4. So 0.3 over 4 is equals to number of moles of oxygen over 3. All right, so here we are multiplying the number of moles. Here we cross multiply. We cross multiply there. So if we cross multiply like this, cross multiply, we are going to have 4, then number of moles of oxygen is actually equivalent. So 4 number of moles of oxygen is equivalent to 0.9. So we divide this one by 4 and we divide that one by 4 so that this and that cancels, so that we know that number of moles of oxygen here, if you punch on your calculator, the number of moles of oxygen, so you can use your calculator, it is allowed in science. So you can divide the 0.4 divided by 0.9 rather, not 4, 0.9 divided by 4, and this one will give us 0.225. So 0.225 moles. All right, we have found the number of moles, but that's not what we want. So again, we convert using the formula, number of moles is equals to mass over molar mass. By now you know that if we cross multiply here, M is going to give us M is equals to number of moles multiplied by molar mass. All right, so that's what we have. So substituting into this equation, we are saying mass here, okay? So we are saying mass is actually equal to the number of moles which we have just found, which is 0.225 moles. Okay, this one should be multiplied by the molar mass. Now oxygen here is O2. Now oxygen, we know it's 16, so 16 times 2, that is our 32. So you multiply now, so this is 32 grams per mole. So 32 grams per more. So you multiply the 0.225 multiplied by 32. So you multiply by 32 grams per mole, and that one is going to give you 7.2 grams. So 7.2 grams, and that is how it is done. So you have found. All right, let's hope this one is clear. Let's deal with the last aspect of calculations from equations in this lesson. All right, so before that, you can practice this question as your exercise. All right, so we now deal with mass to mass calculations. All right, allow me to insist, there are a lot of methods that you can use, but in this lesson, I'm trying to use the simplest method suitable for your understanding and for faster calculations in your exams. All right, so here, the first two, the more to more calculations, we were using the more ratios. But in here, we are going to use the more ratios, but in a slightly different manner. All right, so now here, it is called mass to mass calculations because you have been given the mass of one thing, and you are supposed to use that information to find the mass of another. For example, calculate the mass of calcium chloride, okay? We are calculating the mass of calcium chloride produced when 400 grams of calcium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid. So they've given us the mass of this one. They want us to use that information so that we can find the mass of this one. So two things are of major concern here. So there's calcium carbonate, which is this aspect there. Then they want us to find this mass here. So we are all interested in this guy here and this guy. So as usual, before we can just dive into the calculations, we have to make sure that we write a properly balanced chemical equation. All right, so to find the balanced chemical equation here, let's just check through. We have one calcium there. We have one calcium. We have one carbon. We have one carbon here. Then we have how many oxygen? Okay, we have three oxygens. Then here we have two plus one here, that is three. Then the hydrogens here, we have two. Also the hydrogens, we have two. The chlorine here, we have two. Also there we have two. All right, so that is exactly what we have. So this one is balanced. So now this is what we are going to write, right? So we are going to write, here we are going to write molar mass, okay? Molar mass, mm, of calcium carbonate, which is CaCO3, okay, is equivalent to the molar mass, okay, the molar mass of CaCl2, right? You've seen the way I'm using it, huh? Why? Now, I'm saying molar mass of one because there's an invisible one here, so I also put this one. So here also there's an invisible one, so I also put a one there. Now, when you put a one, it means whatever you're going to find, you multiply by one. Anyway, just hold on and see what you're going to do. Then before you finish, you're also going to say now, this time mass of CaCO3 is equal to the mass of one Ca. So this is one CaCl2, right? Then here you can put a one. So this is a direct proportional ratio that you have made. All right, so having made that one, let me just try to do this one by the side here. So molar mass, we know how to find molar mass. Remember from the previous lesson, we want to find molar mass of calcium carbonate. So this one will just be CaCO3. So just do that. This one will just be 3 times Z. The mass number of this one is actually 16. Then also you go to the carbon here. There's just one carbon. So 1 multiplied by 12. Okay, 1 multiplied by 12. Then Ca, we also have 1 multiplied by 40. So calcium is 40. You check on the periodic table. So you add the total here. We are going to have 3 times 16. That is actually 48. So it will be 48 plus. Okay, so 48. Then 1 times 12. That is actually 12, then plus 40, right? So we add these guys together. You can add them. So 40 plus 12, that is actually 60. 60 plus 40, that is 100. So we're going to have 100 grams per mole, right? So this is what we're going to have. So you are found for this one, right? You are found for this one, okay? So we can erase. Make sure you take note of that one, the 100 grams per mole. If you are watching this video, you can pause right before I erase. Okay, for the sake of space, Let me just erase my board. Okay, so we erase this part there so that we can do so. We found the 100 there. Keep it, don't forget about it. Then we do the same to find, so we follow the same procedure to find, we follow the same procedure to actually find for calcium chloride, which is CaCl2. So following the same procedure, we are going to find 11 grams per mole, right? Following the same procedure as before, this is what you're going to find. So you're just going to say, okay, this is a 40 plus the chlorine here is 35.5 times 2 to give you 71. So when you add this together, you're going to find a 111. All right. So now, having done that, because of this one, so when you multiply 1 times the 100, it will still be 100. 1 times the 11 here, it will still be 11. So now we're going to write, this is the 100, okay? So 100 CaCO3 is actually equal to 111 CaCl2. Okay, we go down here. They've told us this is calcium carbonate, so they've said 40 grams of calcium carbonate. So the 40 will be down here, 40 CaCO3. This one should be equivalent to what we don't know, because we don't know the mass of this one. Then we can cross multiply there. So if we cross multiply, this one is going to be X, okay, is equivalent to, because this X here, actually you're going to have 100X in short. Let's just do it this way to simplify. So 100 times X, we just have 100X is equals to, then 111 times 40. So we can find what 11 times 40 is, and that is 111 times 40. That one is giving us 4440. So that is 4440. Okay, so 4440. Then we divide by 100. So we divide by 100. Even this side, we also divide by 100. So this guy, that guy there goes. Then this one and this one, we are finding actually 44.4 grams. So X is equivalent to 44.4 grams. All right, so 44.4 grams. Now, remember, mass to mass, this is the procedure. So you just have to find the molar mass of one component, you equate it to the molar mass of the component you want. So down, you also find the mass you've been given, also equivalent to the mass of that one. So once you do that one, you'll be able to come up with the correct formula, the correct answer. And you have determined your mass to mass. Now, this one is more convenient, especially in the exam, when you are given in terms of tons. It becomes your easier and the easiest thing to do. That's why I'm saying I'm using the simplest method possible. There are other methods that you meet from other teachers and from other books. They are also workable. They are okay. But I've just tried to use the simplest method that I can use. All right. However, other people find other methods to be simpler and straightforward than these ones here. All right, let's look at the second last example, then we'll be done with this lesson. All right, so considering the reaction below, we have UF4 plus 2mg is equal to this one. So let's just make sure that this one is balanced. Remember, in chemistry, the first thing is always to make sure that the equations are balancing. All right, so here we have 1u, we also have 1u, we have 4F, even here we have 2 times this 2, so 4F. So 2mg, even there, 2mg. So this thing is a business done deal. It's balanced. All right. So how many tons of uranium can be produced in the above reaction? How many tons? You see what I was saying? Tons. How many tons of uranium can be produced in the above reaction using 24 tons of magnesium? So here, 24 tons of magnesium. They've told us. Then they are asking for how many tons of uranium. Uranium is actually how many tons of uranium can be produced. So uranium is this one here. So we are interested in these two ticked ones. So we are simply saying they we are simply saying, because there's a two in front. So we are going to say here we are going to say molar mass. Okay, so we start molar mass 2mg. Okay, 2mg is equal to, also here we're going to say molar mass, okay, molar mass of this is just U. So one U. Then we also equally say, okay, even the mass of the mass of Mg here, you just say mass of Mg should be equivalent to the mass of U, right? Then we begin to substitute. Now this is Mg. Mg, we know the mass number is 24, but there's a 2 in front, so it will be 24 times 2, which will be 48. So we're going to have something like 48 Mg. 48 Mg is equivalent to, so uranium here, if we check on the periodic table, okay, so we can check for uranium on the periodic table and find out how much it is. Right, so uranium, I'm just trying to check. So you can check for uranium on the periodic table. What is the mass number of uranium? Right, so let me just check on my periodic table so that we move at the same page. So checking the periodic table, I'm sure by now you know that whenever you are learning chemistry, you also need a periodic table. Okay, so mass of uranium, let me just check for it on the periodic table. These are some of the atoms that we are not really used to. Okay, so this one is about 238. All right, let's just take it as 238. So this one will be 238 U, okay? Then the mass we've been given here, they've said 24 tons. So here, I'm just going to put 24, all right? This is equal to X because we don't know for uranium. So we cross multiply that one. So cross multiplying that one, we are actually having 48x, okay? 48x is equals to, so punch on your calculator there, we are saying 238. So according to your calculator, you punch, make sure you're using the scientific calculator, not for your phone. So 238, you multiply by 24, and you have 5712. So we're going to have 5712, all right? So 5712, you divide by 48. Also this side, you divide by 48. All right, let's see what you're going to have. So you can still rely on your calculator, this is chemistry. So X will be equal to, so we are dividing this one by 48. So you divide by 48. Then you have 119. So X is equals to 119 tons. All right, so that is how it is done. Ladies and gentlemen, please feel free to play, pause the video, and you consider this one. So more concept is a wide topic. We have done 2 lessons so far. We still have quite a few lessons to go before we are done. We are just beginning. All right, so just a quick summary over what we have done, the mass-to-mass calculations. We have said this one, please just follow the format, this one that you are doing. So the first thing, balance the equation. After balancing the equations, figure out which elements you are interested, elements or compound, or let me just say species that you are interested in. After figuring out, please make sure that whatever mass numbers you're going to find, you multiply with this number in front here. That's why I was putting it here. Then make sure if for example magnesium is the mass number, even here it should be mass for magnesium. So write them in this order and everything is going to be simple and straightforward. All right, please keep doing what you're doing, and we shall continue in the other lessons. Make sure that you understand this concept because it might be useful in the next lesson. So in chemistry, we keep on building from one step to another. All right, thank you, and we'll see you in the next lesson.